tell us the story. Okay. So we had to fly out to Los Angeles to record this album, and we had this song called Punchdrunk, and the producer was like, you know, it's missing kind of the lead part, and we were like, yeah, maybe. And George Harrison's flying from London to Hawaii, but he's layover in Los Angeles for 2 days. And a mutual friend of ours was picking him up, and he was playing the demos in the car. And he asked to hear that song a couple of times. And then about 3 or 4 weeks later, he was back in his home in London. And he rang up and he said, you know, I was out gardening and I had this song in my head and I couldn't figure out what song it was. And he said, I think it's those young kids from Ireland. So he said, I've got this guitar part, look, I don't know if you want it or not. So, well, I think it's funny. The second Christmas, we were coming home to Cork for Christmas. And we were mixing the song in Miami, right, South Beach. So like there's fucking three of us there sitting down in our white fronts on the beach in South Beach. Fucking pork pink sign, fucking guts hanging out. We're like, geez, can't wait to get home to the Washington of pints and Christmas and great crack. And what about this George Harrison fella? Are we gonna use it or not? Like, you can't have a beat to play with rack or a take from it. Yeah, we had to catch ourselves, like, look at that fucking state of us. We're here wondering whether it's a good idea to have a Beatle player in your album. Get real, motherfuckers, you know? So anyway, we decided to, you know, we give him a thumbs up. He was a good man. So anyway, this is the song. And we actually have George Harrison's part. We've kept it on tape. And on nights like this, we play to his track. So we have a Beatle in the White Horse tonight. So that is kind of very haunting.
So how did we get to play with Beatle Day?